Hello everyone, I am Saurabh Pandey, this is SQL Depository, and you are watching module number 5 of Postgres Administration. In the last video, we have learned about Postgres architecture, and in this video, we will see the background processes of Postgres. But first, I will add the Postgres user into the sudoers group. Right now, it is not part of sudoers group, and just to verify, I will try to access a directory where Postgres will not have any access. So for this, I will write list directory ls home ubuntu and it says permission denied. So this time I will try to access the same directory using the root permission. So for this I will write sudo ls home ubuntu. Okay, and it says Postgres is not in the sudoers file, the incident will be reported. So Postgres user is definitely not part of sudoers group. Now I will add this user into the sudoers group, and for this I will have to switch to a user which already has the root access, which is already part of sudoers group. And for this I will use ubuntu user. So for this I will write su space hyphen space ubuntu, then the password for ubuntu user, and then I will write sudo space usermod space hyphen small a capital G sudo postgres. Hit enter. Now Postgres user is part of sudoers group. So I will switch back to Postgres user. For this I will write su space hyphen space postgres. Hit enter the password for Postgres user. And now I will try to access the same directory again, and this time we will see if it will allow me to see the content of the directory or not. So for this I will write sudo space ls space home ubuntu. This is the home directory of ubuntu user, and if I hit enter I can see the content inside the home directory of ubuntu. Now I can see the files. So Postgres user has been added to the sudoers group, which is good. Now we will see the background processes of Postgres instance. So for this I will type ps space hyphen ef grep postgres, and then you can see couple of processes here which are checkpointer, background writer, wall writer, logical replication writer, auto vacuum launcher. So these are the background processes, and as I told you in my last video that Postmaster is the process that maintain these processes. So what I'll do, I'll kill one of these processes, and then we'll see if Postmaster process was able to start the process again or not. So for this, if you'll see the ID of auto vacuum launcher process, it is 1798. I will kill this ID, and then we will run the same command again to check if auto vacuum launcher is again up or not. So I will write kill, and the ID is 1798, but don't do it in your production environment. Hit enter and then run the same command again. And this time I will see auto vacuum launcher process. The ID has been changed. It is 2098, right? So the Postmaster process has started the process again, and that is why the ID has been changed. So Postmaster process is maintaining all these background processes, and we could successfully see that. So this is what I wanted to cover in this video. In the next video, I will restore the sample database named DVD rental. Thank you for watching this.